I'm going to describe an animal. If you think you know what animal I'm talking about, put your finger on your nose. Let's see how long it takes for everyone to guess. Ready? This animal can be white, brown, black, or spotted. This animal can be soft and cuddly. This animal isn't very smart. This animal eats grass and goes baa. Wow, I see lots of fingers on your noses. On the count of three, which animal am I talking about? One, two, three. You're right, a sheep. Now, what is someone called who takes care of sheep? A shepherd. Sheep need a shepherd because they're not very smart. They can't find good food or water on their own. Sometimes they lose their way and get lost and hurt. They need the shepherd to love them and care for them. The Bible says you and I are like sheep. Sometimes we lose our way too. We lose our way because of sin. We need someone who loves us and can take care of us and help us recognize our sin and turn to God, the great shepherd. That someone is Jesus. Jesus loves you and cares for you so much. He made a way for your sin to be forgiven. Say it with me. Jesus forgives sin. Peter and the other disciples were eating a special meal with Jesus. During the meal, Jesus said soon he would be arrested and bad things were going to happen to him. Peter couldn't believe it. Peter promised Jesus that he would go to prison or even die for Jesus. But Jesus said something shocking to Peter. I tell you, Peter, before the rooster crows today, you will deny me three times that you know me. Basically, Jesus was telling Peter that Peter would lie about knowing or following Jesus. How could that be? Peter was one of Jesus' disciples. After eating the meal, Jesus and the disciples went to the Garden of Gethsemane to pray. Suddenly, soldiers appeared and they tied Jesus up and led him away. Peter decided to follow the soldiers and see where they took Jesus. Quietly, Peter followed the soldiers to the high priest's house. The high priest was a religious leader who had a lot of power, but he hated Jesus and wanted Jesus to die. As Peter was watching and listening to what was going on in the courtyard, a servant girl noticed Peter and said, "Hey, this man was with Jesus. You're one of his followers." But Peter said, "I don't know Jesus. I don't know this man." A second time, someone asked Peter if he knew Jesus, and again, Peter denied it. A little while later, someone else questioned Peter, and again, he strongly denied, "I don't know Jesus, I don't know that man, I never followed him." Three times, Peter said, "I don't know him," just like Jesus said would happen. Peter had done a terrible, sinful thing. He denied the Lord. He lied about being one of Jesus' followers because he was afraid something bad would happen to him. Can you imagine how sad and sorry Peter felt? He had told Jesus he would even go to prison, even die for Jesus, and here he was, letting his fear overtake him and causing him to lie. The Bible says Peter went out of that place crying. Even though Jesus had done nothing wrong, he was put on trial and sentenced to die by being nailed to a cross. He was beaten with whips and had a crown of thorns pressed onto his head. The soldiers made him carry his cross to the hill where he was crucified. This was one of the worst ways criminals were punished in Jesus' day. One of the disciples, John, was with them when Jesus was on the cross. We don't know where the other disciples were. Was Peter there watching from a distance? Or did Peter stay away, feeling unworthy and unforgivable? The Bible doesn't tell us. But to all who love Jesus, this was a terrible, terrible day. How could God allow Jesus to suffer and die? But this was part of God's plan. On the third day, Peter heard the great and most unbelievable news that some woman had told him, that Jesus was alive and his tomb was empty. And we know all this story. But sometimes we sin and we do terrible things we think are unforgivable. Just like Peter, when Peter promised Jesus that he would follow him forever, and yet because he felt afraid, he denied knowing Jesus. And we might feel unworthy at times when we sin, as if God doesn't care about us anymore because we did something terrible and something so bad. But you know, when we feel ashamed and disappointed in ourselves, it's important to remember that God is our gracious Father. He is merciful and forgiving. When we ask Jesus for forgiveness, He forgives of our sins. Next week, we're going to find out what happened when Jesus reappeared before Peter. Will Jesus forgive Peter? We'll find out next week.